Hey everyone, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and this video is our beginner's guide to the most common types of audio connectors and cables that you're going to be using either at home, at a gig, or in a recording studio. Now, we've all been there once. You've just bought yourself a brand new bit of gear, be it something for your guitar rig, home studio, or PA system. You've got it home, and disaster. You haven't actually bought the correct cables to connect it all up. It's an easy mistake to make, as there are quite a few different types of audio connector out there. Some of them look very similar, and quite often, the same type of connectors are referred to by completely different names. So in this guide, we're just going to run through the six most common types of audio connector and what they're used for. So hopefully next time you're in one of our stores confronted by that huge wall of cables, you'll know exactly what you're looking for. Just before we get started though, a quick bit of jargon busting for you. Now, I'm not going to be going into the science behind this here, but throughout the video, I will be using the terms balanced and unbalanced. Unbalanced connectors send their signal over two core cable, and this is commonly used for the likes of guitars and line level outputs such as keyboards and DJ mixers. Whereas a balanced connector utilises three core cable, and they're more commonly used for microphones, PA and studio gear. Balanced cable, however, is more suitable for sending a signal over a long distance. So if you've ever wondered why a sound engineer at a gig will always plug an electroacoustic guitar or a bass into what's known as a DI box, what they're doing is converting your guitar's unbalanced signal into a balanced signal, so it can be sent to the mixing desk at the back of the room without picking up any unwanted noise or interference, whilst maintaining a strong undegraded signal. For short distances, such as from a guitar to an amp, this isn't really necessary, which is why most instruments and line level outputs will use unbalanced cables and connectors. So speaking of which, that's probably a good place to start in terms of connectors, as if you are a guitarist, this is probably the most common connector that you're going to be using. It's the quarter inch mono jack. These are also known by other names such as a 6.3mm jack, a mono jack, a standard jack, a guitar jack, a high Z jack, and on rarer occasions, they might even be referred to as a phone jack, as they're similar in design to the connectors used on old phone switching boards. But definitely don't confuse this with a phono connector. Standard quarter inch jacks are identified by their pointed tip and then sleeve connections, separated by a single black insulation hoop. As the tip carries the signal and the sleeve the earth, this type of connector will only carry a mono signal. As I just mentioned, they're mostly used for high impedance instruments such as guitars, keyboards and electronic drum kits. So if you did want to connect, let's say a stereo keyboard with both a left and a right output to your PA system, you will need two cables. Quite usefully, this type of jack connector is also quite common in a right angled version, making it more suitable for certain types of guitar or to save space when you're connecting effects pedals together. Now, quarter inch jack connectors are also commonly used for speaker cables, especially the ones used to connect a guitar head to a cabinet. Speaker cables, however, use unshielded cable, which are much more prone to interference. So to avoid any unwanted noise or buzzing, etc., always check that you're using a shielded instrument cable when connecting guitars and other instruments to an amplifier. And on the flip side, never use a shielded guitar cable to connect a speaker to an amplifier, as you can damage your amp. Next up is a connector that looks very similar, but it's used for totally different purposes. It's the quarter inch or 6.3mm stereo jack. These are capable of carrying a stereo signal. The tip and ring connections carry the left and right signal, and the sleeve connection the common earth. Due to this tip ring sleeve design, they're also known as TRS jacks, suitable for carrying a balanced signal on three core cable, hence why they're also sometimes referred to as a balanced jack. Identifiable by their twin insulation hoops, these are most commonly used to connect to a stereo output of a larger style headphone socket on a guitar amp, effects unit, digital drum kit, or recording interface. They can be used to carry the send and return signal of a Y cable, commonly used for connecting outboard effects to the insert point of a mixing desk. Or if they're used with a balanced cable, they can be used with the TRS inputs and outputs, commonly found on home studio interfaces and reference monitors. Our next audio connector is a shrunken down version of the 6.3mm stereo jack, known commonly as the stereo mini jack, 3.5mm jack, 1/8 jack or headphone jack, and they're used almost exclusively to connect to headphone sockets and line level inputs and outputs. For example, this is probably the connector you'll need if you want to plug your phone or tablet into your guitar amplifier. They are also available in a mono version, but in the world of musical instruments, these only really tend to be used for patching vintage and retro synthesizers together. If you've ever set up a home hi-fi before, you'll probably already be familiar with the next connector we're looking at, the RCA Phono. These are frequently found on DJ mixers, hi-fi equipment, studio interfaces, and on the tape in and out connections on a PA mixing desk. And you may even have seen this type of connector being used for component video inputs and outputs, usually on older TVs and games consoles pre-HDMI. Fun fact, well, probably not that fun, but an interesting little bit of history. RCA is actually an acronym for Radio Corporation of America, who developed this type of plug back in the 1940s. So you might have also heard people referring to these type of connectors as just either an RCA plug, phono plug, or probably slightly incorrectly, an auxiliary cable. Phono cables are usually used to carry an unbalanced stereo signal, but as each RCA connector is only mono, it means that you'll usually find this type of connector attached to a cable in pairs, either two on each end, or maybe a pair of phonos with a stereo jack on the other end, depending on what you're connecting the cable to. In most audio equipment, the red connector usually indicates the right-hand side of the stereo mix, whilst the black or white connector carries the left signal. It won't damage any of your equipment if you do mix these up, it just means that the stereo image of what you're listening to may be reversed. If you're a live sound or studio engineer, the connector you're likely to be using the most is the XLR, with the most common variant in the world of music being the 3-pin XLR, although you might also come across 5 or 7-pin versions being used on stage lighting rigs. The 3-pin XLR carries a balanced signal, and they're used for most microphones, especially mics that require 48 volt phantom power, DI boxes, outputs on mixing desks, and inputs on active speaker cabinets. XLR connectors come in two versions, male or female. Without wanting to sound too crude, the male connectors are the ones with the three little connection poles, whilst the females have the three little holes. So with that in mind, a male XLR socket on a mic or mixing desk is usually an audio output, and a female XLR socket on a mixing desk or an active speaker cabinet will be an input. Sometimes referred to as a Canon connector or simply just a mic lead, one great advantage of the XLR is that because most mic cables will have a male connection on one end and a female on the other, you can easily connect two or more cables together if you need more length. And because they do offer a balanced connection, they're suitable for carrying a signal over quite long cable runs. The final audio connector that we're looking at today has a variety of uses, as they're available with either 2, 4 or 8 pole internal wiring options. But for live sound, these plugs and sockets are most commonly used to connect speaker cabs to amplifiers, pretty easy to remember as they're known as speak-on connectors. Now sometimes you might hear people referring to these as Nutrik connectors, the name of the company that developed this design, a bit like when people call a vacuum cleaner a Hoover. They've been designed to carry a high current signal and accommodate really thick cable, which is what makes them perfect for connecting between a high power PA amplifier and a speaker cabinet. And it's also not uncommon to find this kind of connector on a bass amp head and cab as well. You'll usually find a female speak-on connector on each end of a speaker cable, whilst the male versions tend to be used as sockets on amps and speaker cabs. Their rugged design and twist lock connection make them really sturdy and reliable, and an added advantage is that they also use solderless, screwed-in connections, making wiring up speak-on plugs really quick and easy. So there we go. That was a quick guide to the 6 most common types of audio connector and cable that you're going to see on the walls of your local PMT store. I hope that's helped to explain things a little, but if you are still a bit confused, don't be afraid to ask the guys and girls in store. They're a friendly bunch and they'll be happy to help. For more information on our full range of cables and accessories, do visit pmtonline.co.uk, or as I said, get down to your nearest store. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button and ring the notifications bell. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. That's PMT House of Rock. So thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon.